Today we're going to take a look at a reversible steel mill engine. And they had to be able to roll smoothly under high pressure, and they had to be able to reverse quickly, and the engineer could do that very easily with this rig. And this is a pretty darn accurate representation of this 1895 steel mill engine from Middlesbrough in the UK. And here we have a very highly detailed piece. You can see it's got helical gears just like the original would have. These helical gears were required when you're rolling out sheet metal. If you had straight cut gears, you would leave ridges in your surface of your sheet metal and it would not look too pretty. And then you have beautiful little oilers that they built, and this is a mechanical oiler, and I'll demonstrate that when it's running in a moment. And up here you can see the oil line coming up to feed the cylinders, steam cylinder oil. And there's a little pressure gauge right there. Here's a few more little details. This one valve will drain condensate from here, from the inlet manifold, and from both steam chests, one on each end. And it all comes out down here. And another safety feature it had, I am assuming the original had, is this pin, which locks the throttle. So it'll lock it in the closed position for safety reasons. And once you pull this pin out, once the operator pulled the pin out, he could then run the engine. Like so. But the engineer would stand in this area, and he could turn on here. He's got an overhead throttle for main steam feed. Here's a hand throttle that'll work very quickly. And he needed to be able to act quickly to reverse this thing in probably under 30 seconds. He could shut the mill down, like shut it right down like that, and reverse it like this. You can see that quadrant right there. Then you could turn it back on, like so. And what you've got is a very highly detailed, very beautifully made model. This was one man's work for 10 years he put into this project. Ate up a lot of his spare time, as you can see. It's a working governor. The governor is connected from here over to here and right up to here. There's the, you can see it's moving slightly right there. This is the other side is the throttle side, and you can see that here. The cylinder and the cylinder castings and these frames, the A-frames, are Stuart Turner number 4. The entire rest of it is hand-fabricated by Peter Tarn, a true master of his craft. Now here, you can see this mechanical lubricator. And we'll flip this over, and then it starts reacting. There's a ratchet-driven pump inside this box. And here's your is an eccentric here. This is what drives the oil pump. It comes right off of here, off this little, it's like a crank off the end of the big gear. And this rod goes underneath all the way over to here to the oil pump. Now, we can try reversing it again like the engineer would have done. There we go. You can see that governor trying to work a little bit there. This is on about a little under 7.5 PSI. She just runs like a Swiss watch. There we go. Well, I hope you enjoyed it, and thanks for watching.